Friends, welcome to video 13A. And in fact, this is not a video where I'm going to share something new. Actually, it's a quiz. This quiz is about classification of data. So let's get going. What I'm going to do in later slides is I'm going to provide you certain information or data. What you're required to do is recognize whether the information that I've given belongs to which of the following categories. You've already been familiar with these seven ideas from accounting, where you know that once you master these seven ideas, you can actually build the entire superstructure of accounting. Which are those seven ideas? Expenses, income, inflow, outflow, asset, liability, and equity. So what you're going to do is, once I give you that data, you're going to classify that within those seven buckets. And as I have shared in one of the earlier videos, these seven ideas actually map into three financial statements: statement of profit and loss, balance sheet, and cash flow statement. So we know that expenses and income map into statement of profit and loss, inflow outflow map into cash flow statement, asset liability equity map into the balance sheet. So what you're going to require to do is not only do the classification, but also think of which financial statement will capture that data. So let's get going. So here is question one. The data given to you is owned office equipment being used at head office. Now this is the data. You have to tell me which category does it belong to out of those seven, and then which financial statement would capture it. I'm sure you guessed it right. This is an asset and it will be in the balance sheet. That's right. I hope you got the drift of how this quiz is. So let's go to the next quizzes now. Q2, question 2. Raw materials consumed during the year. So here is an example of a resource which has been used up during the year. Can you think of which category does it belong to? Expense. And it will be found in the statement of P&L, or as some countries call it, income statement. These two are synonymous terms. Of course, we are going to discuss these statements more in detail later on. But remember, here our focus is not on the payment that we have made to the vendors, but it is on the raw materials which have actually been consumed. And expenses are about resources being used or consumed. Materials in process at the end of the year. You have brought raw materials, you are processing them, they are not yet finished, and they are a part of your own property, they are a part of your inventory, and you want to know where you would classify this materials in process at the end of the year. Any guess? That's your asset, and that should be a part of your balance sheet. In other words, your inventory is a part of your assets, and that should be a part of the balance sheet. Let's go to Q5 now. Quiz 5. Balance in bank account at the end of the year. Balance in bank account at the end of the year. You guessed it right, it's an asset. It is not an inflow or outflow. Actually, balance in bank account is a result of three things. The balance at the beginning of the year plus the inflows and minus the outflows. That gives you balance in bank account at the end of the year. But balance in bank account at the end of the year is not an inflow or outflow, but rather an asset. Why do we say so? When we have money in the bank account, we have a claim on the bank. And any claim on any other party, whether it's customer or bank or the central bank, is an asset for us. Remember that? We had discussed that in one of the earlier videos. And that should be in the balance sheet. Absolutely. Let's go to Q6. Q6. Sale of scrap during the year. This is not your main business, but in the production process, certain scrap gets generated and you are selling it. So that's your income. And because it's your income, it should be in the statement of profit and loss or in the income statement. Great. Let's go to the Q7. Quiz 7. Amount of unpaid bank loan at the end of the year. This is something that you have taken a loan, you have not yet paid back to the bank. Can you guess what it would be? I think you guessed it right. It's a liability, and any liability is always a part of the balance sheet. Absolutely. Q8 now. Advertising cost incurred during the year? Yes, it's like the raw materials example. It should be expenses, should be part of statement of profit and loss or income statement. Receivables from customers at the end of the year. Receivables means we have supplied goods, we have supplied services, but we have not yet collected money. Any such claim on the customer has value, and therefore it is an asset and it would be in the balance sheet. Great. Q10. Dues to vendors at the end of the year. This means we owe something to our own vendors who have given us goods and services. Isn't it exactly opposite of the receivables? Yes. Sometimes companies call this as accounts payable, but it means the same thing. This is a liability and it should be in the balance sheet. That's great. I think you would have cracked most of them. Congratulations. Shareholders' equity at the end of the year. This is one more. At the end of the year, the investment that is done by the shareholders in the company, this will be part of equity, and equity is also part of the balance sheet. That's great. So, friends, I look forward to your participation in videos that are coming up. Do subscribe, add the playlist to your library. I'm going to add some more videos, even as suffixes to the earlier videos. I'm going to add some quizzes like this one. Try those quizzes also. Thank you.